NASA has just released a breathtaking HD video that its latest Mars rover Perseverance captured during its epic landing on surface of Mars inside the Jezero crater on Thursday, 18th Feb. It takes us on a journey along with Perseverance. Humans have never seen anything like this before. According to acting NASA Administrator Steve, for those who wonder how you land on Mars or why it is so difficult or how cool it would be to do so, you need to look no further. Now, it's not the Perseverance is the first robot to document its landing on Mars. Its predecessor, NASA's Curiosity rover, also captured images of its own touchdown in August 2012. It was named 7 Minutes of Terror, as NASA's spacecraft take about 7 minutes to reach the land after hitting the top of planet's atmosphere. And the trip down is full of panic for scientists, as it is hazardous in many ways. A thousand things can go wrong. Landing safely is never a guarantee. But the entry, descent, and landing footage that came from Curiosity was nowhere close as sharp or complete as the one sent by Perseverance. For example, we did get to see Curiosity's heat shield fall away, but the footage stopped long before it could actually touch the land, and it had nowhere near as many viewpoints as its successor. Perseverance had multiple cameras on the rover's protective back shell, one on the bottom of the sky crane and two on itself, one that looked up and another that looked down. Together, all these cameras captured more than 20,000 images during Perseverance descent. Then a team stitched the photos together to produce the video, which begins about 230 seconds into the Perseverance 7 Minutes of Terror. What we have seen here today is really nothing short of amazing. Thomas, Associate Administrator of NASA's Science Mission Directorate, said during his news conference, "That video, I believe, should become mandatory viewing for young people who not only want to explore other worlds and build spacecraft to take them there, but also want to be part of diverse teams of achieving all the audacious goals of our future." It was this comprehensive EDL imagery that helped scientists pinpoint where Perseverance accessory pieces touched down. What is more is that Perseverance camera also have microphone. Now, taking microphones to Mars isn't new either. NASA's Mars Polar Lander spacecraft sported a mic, and the Phoenix lander had one built into its descent camera, but unfortunately, neither of those instruments returned any Martian sound. Mars Polar Lander crashed during its touchdown attempt in December 1999, and Phoenix mic was never turned on out of concern that its use could interfere with the spacecraft's landing. But now, we have our first ever true Martian audio, courtesy of Perseverance EDL mic. It had some initial problems. It did not work during the anti-descent and landing to catch rushing Martian winds as planned. But it did switch on after the touchdown. But how did it land? The landing strategy of Perseverance and Curiosity were more or less the same, as they both relied on supersonic parachutes and a rocket-powered sky crane, among other things. On February 18th, the most important part of the rover's journey began, its landing. Before entering the Mars surface, Perseverance was blazing at around 12,100 miles an hour. As you might guess, that is much too fast to land safely. But once it hit the planet's atmosphere, the drag on a spacecraft from the air slowed its descent to make it less than 1,000 miles an hour. Then a supersonic parachute slowed it to about 200 miles an hour. But the thing is that Mars air is much too thin for parachute alone to safely land such a heavy machine. Perseverance is almost a car. It's around a ton. So it had to perform a sequence of carefully choreographed maneuvers to further slow the rover. Furthermore, the landing site Jezero, with its cliff edges, sand traps, and problematic boulders, was another challenge. It really needed some serious upgrade on the previous landing technology. For example, an automated software was used to help the rover guide itself a problem-free landing zone while it was descending. Scientists previously used to compromise on where they want to land, based on the landing technology they had. But this time, they took it as a challenge. After its chutes were deployed, the heat shield was ditched, and a safe spot to land was found. Perseverance completed the last part of its landing with the help of somewhat exotic sound device called a sky crane. It is basically a rocket-powered jetpack. It lowers the rover on tether. As we just discussed, Curiosity 2 used a sky crane to safely land, but it was solely relied on parachutes and onboard retro rockets, or a cocoon of 24 airbags. But again, with a rover as heavy as the Perseverance, those methods would not work. After separating from the parachute, the sky crane retro rocket slowed the rover's descent to roughly 17 miles an hour. Then, about 70 feet above the ground, it started lowering the rover to the ground using three nylon cables. Once the tethers were severed, the sky crane flew off far away to Pluto. Just kidding. Just enough to avoid complicating the rover's surface operation. Perseverance will push the boundaries of exploration in many, many ways. But how? That we will know in the days to come. It will hunt for the signs of ancient life, even microorganisms. It will also be the first ever mission that will try to get Mars samples back to Earth. It will collect and store dozens of samples with especially high astrobiological potential, which a joint NASA European Space Agency campaign will bring to Earth as early as 2031. What will we learn from it? We will have to see. Thank you so much for watching this video. And if you like our content, then do not forget to share and subscribe with your friends, family, and whomever you know. As NASA's spacecraft, as it is hazardous, it takes us on a long